The entropy of a system can actually be described mathematically. Suppose you had a very small system of 4 molecules, and the net energy of these 4 molecules was 5 joules. You know from Chem 101 that the energy levels in atoms are quantized. Molecules also have quantized energy levels associated with their rotational, translational, and vibrational motion. Suppose that the quantized energy levels for these molecules was either 0 or 5 joules and nothing in between. Well, for 4 molecules to add up to 5 joules, we can have a combination where one of the molecules is at 5 joules and the other 3 are at 0. Or a different molecule is at 5 joules, or a different molecule is at 5 joules, or a different molecule is at 5 joules and the rest at 0. So you have 4 possible ways to distribute 5 joules of energy in this system. Now, suppose you were at a different phase of the material and the quantized energy levels for the molecules was now 0, 1, 2, or 3. First off, there would be a few ways to arrange the molecules at energy levels that add up to 5 joules. The best way to do this is to be systematic. The highest energy level is 3, and to add up to 5, we would have 2, 0, and 0. We could also have 3, 1, 1, and 0. If we started out with 2, we might have another molecule at 2, another at 1, and 0. Or we could have 2, 1, 1, and 1. All 4 subsets here have a net energy of 5 joules. However, within the subsets, there'd be different molecules at each energy. So let's look at the subset which has energies 3, 2, 0, and 0 in detail. These are all the ways that you could have 4 molecules at energies 3, 2, 0, and 0. Notice that there are 12 of them. Each one of these combinations is a unique way to give 5 joules of energy. You can go through this exercise for the other subsets by yourself, and you'll find that for the one shown, there were 12 ways. If you go through the 3110 subset, there are 12 ways. Also for the 2210 subset, there are 12 ways. And the 2111 subset has only 4 ways to distribute. The net sum of all these ways is 40. So let's compare the two systems. When energy levels are far apart, there are 4 ways. When energy levels are close together, there are 40 ways. So obviously the system on the right has a great deal more entropy when the energy levels are closer together. This might be an example of water in the liquid state going to water in the gaseous state. Gas is considered to be a much higher entropic system than liquid. There are more elegant ways to do the math. Suppose you had 4 molecules that could have quantized energy 0 or 5 joules, and the net energy of these 4 molecules was 5 joules. How many ways is the energy distributed? Well, I showed you one way looking at the combination of subsets. There is one subset with a net energy of 5 joules, and that is 5000. In order to figure out how many distributions there are within a subset, the formula is shown here. It is the combination of n molecules at k energy levels. N stands for the number of molecules in the system. K is for each molecule at an energy level within the subset. So if we look at this set right here, there are four total molecules. There is one molecule at energy level 5. There are three molecules at energy level 0. When you work through the math, the value of 4 factorial divided by 1 factorial 3 factorial is 4. There are 4 ways to have this set at 5, 0, 0, 0. Now, you probably wouldn't go to all this trouble for such a simple example, but how about the one where the energy levels are closer together? Here is the formula for this one. Once again, we have N, which is the number of molecules in the system, and we can have energy level 3, 2, 1, or 0. So let's identify the subsets and use combinations to determine the number possible for each subset. Here are the subsets found on the previous slides. If we have subsets where one molecule is at 3, one is at 2, and 2 are at 0, the combination is 4 factorial. We have one molecule at 3, so that's 1 factorial. One molecule at 2, so that is also 1 factorial. There are no molecules at the 1 energy level, so that is 0 factorial. And there are 2 molecules at energy level 0, so that is 2 factorial. Remember that 0 factorial is 1, so when we're finished, this is 1 times 2 times 3 times 4, divided by a bunch of 1s and 2. This winds up to be 12. Here's the breakdown for the 3110 subset. There are 4 molecules. One of them is at 3, none of them are at 2, 2 molecules are at energy level 1, and 1 molecule is at energy level 0. This factorial also sums up to 12. For the 221 example, there are no molecules at 3, 2 at energy level 2, 1 at energy level 1, and 1 at energy level 1. So this is again 12. For the last combination, 2111, there are no molecules at 3, 1 molecule at 2, 3 molecules at 1, and no molecules at 0. 4 factorial divided by this denominator, which has 3 factorial, turns out to be the value 4. Sum these all together, and we get 40 ways. Now, this works provided you're methodical about spotting the subsets. There's also a more elegant way of doing the math using polynomial expansion. If your energy choices for the molecules are 0, 1, 2, or 3, the polynomial you make is 1 plus x plus x squared plus x cubed, and you raise that to the 4th power because there are 4 molecules. You can type this polynomial into a program that will give you the polynomial expansion, and you will notice that in front of the 5, which represents 5 joules of energy, we have the value 40. This tells us there are 40 ways to distribute the molecules at 5 joules of energy. Here's another example of the combination. Suppose that you have 4 molecules and their quantized energy levels are 0, 1, or 2, and the net energy of these 4 molecules was 5 joules. How many ways is the energy distributed? Our energy choices are 0, 1, or 2, so that makes our polynomial 1 plus x squared. We would raise this to the 4th power for our 4 molecules. And with our polynomial expansion, notice that 16 is in front of x to the 5th. There are 16 ways to distribute in this system having a net energy of 5 joules. Let's try one last example. Here are two diagrams which show the energy of 3A particles and 3B particles. What is the energy of system A? That would be 1 plus 2 plus 3, so that would give us a value of 6. What is the energy of system B? That would be 0 plus 2 plus 2, so this gives us an energy of 4. How many ways can the energy of system A be distributed? If you like to use the combination method and be methodical about it, there are several ways that you can add up to 6. There is 3, 3, 0, 3, 2, 1, which is the combination shown, or 2, 2, 2. Remember that on top is the factorial representing the number of molecules, so that would be 3 factorial. On the bottom represents the number of molecules at each energy level. For 3, 3, 0, there would be 2 molecules at energy 3, none at 2, none at 1, and 1 at 0. 3 factorial divided by this denominator is 3. For the 3, 2, 1 example, there would be 3 factorial molecules, and we have 1 factorial for 1 at energy 3, 1 factorial for 1 at energy 2, 1 factorial for 1 at energy 1, and 0 factorial for none at energy 0. 3 factorial divided by this denominator gives us a value of 6. Last is the example 222, 3 factorial for 3 molecules, and there are no molecules at 3, 1, or 0. But there are 3 of them at energy level 2. So as you can see, there is only one way to make 222. This is 3 factorial divided by 3 factorial. When you add 3 plus 6 plus 1, you get 10. If you'd like to do this using the polynomial expansion method, there are 4 energy levels, 0, 1, 2, or 3, and there are 3 molecules. When you do this polynomial expansion, look for the term in front of x to the 6th, since this is the energy we're trying to get. Notice that there is a 10, and that's the same answer we got using combinations. Let's look at question D. How many ways can the energy of system B be distributed? In order to have energy 4, there is no energy level 4 in this diagram. Our choices are only 0 or 2. So there's really only one combination, 2, 2, and 0. And if we were going to count the number of ways you can have this combination, it would be 3 factorial for the number of molecules, and there are 2 molecules at energy level 2 and 1 molecule at energy level 0. 3 factorial divided by 2 factorial gives us 3. If you like the polynomial expansion method, there are energy levels 0 or 2. So I will take 1 plus x squared as my polynomial and raise it to the 3rd power for my 3 molecules. This is the polynomial expansion, and you notice that in front of x to the 4th, we have a number 3. So, which system has the greatest entropy? A, because it can be distributed 10 ways, compared to B, which can be distributed only 3. This concludes a statistical discussion of entropy.